Varam Shlishi, Vatikvar Nalai Kulchem. Klai Yisrael comes running all towards Moshe Rabbeinu. Rashi says, Barvuvya, in a confusion. Little kids running in front of big ones. What they want? Moshe Rabbeinu is repeating the story of the Meraglim. They came and they said, hey, we want to send spies there to find out. Why do we have to tell you? What's the point of telling you that they all came in a hullabaloo? Who cares? The answer, simple answer is, do not justify yourself and say afterwards, we started with the proper intentions. Something went wrong with the Meraglim. To begin with, it wasn't good. And we find the opposite by Matan Torah. Klal Yisrael goes to Matan Torah. They let all the Zakenim, the older people, go in the front nicely. There was a tain on Klal Yisrael. Comes to the Torah, you're not in such a rush. You let everybody else go. Comes there, it's Yisrael, the piece of land, the piece of real estate. Vayachperu lonu esaretz. Let us go spy out the land. But we don't want to spy out for the Zakenim. They don't care. We need it for ourselves. So you ask for Meraglim. It says, Vayitav be'enei Moshe. Moshe Rabbeinu said, you know what? Fine, you want to get Meraglim? I'll go. We'll try it out. What do you mean? He just meant to say, if I say yes, they'll say, all right, if he's not against it, he's pro it, maybe they'll even give up. Like somebody wants to buy a donkey from somebody. The guy says, can I try out your donkey? Sure. Can I try it on the mountain? Sure. Can I try it on the hill? Sure. The valley? Yeah. The guy says, all right, fine, I'll buy it. I don't even have to test it if you're asking to everything. Then what happened? He picked 12 different great people to be the Meraglim, but nobody from Shevet Levi. They come back and they say, Toivah Oretz Ma'od. Even the 10 that we consider as the Meraglim came back and said, it was a beautiful land, Eretz Ovis Chalav Advash. But then they said, there's only one problem. We will not be able to capture it. It's a land that eats up its inhabitants. It's impossible to fight them. Not just that, there is great big giants there, big cities, fortified cities. There's no way we can capture it. Why did Hashem take us out of Mitzrayim, which was great? Revisionists of history, of course. Mitzrayim was great. Let's go back there. And I told them, what do you mean? Don't you see the Rebbeinu Shlomo has been keeping you going for so much time in the Midbar with nothing? Why don't you believe? What happened to your Amunah? Vayikatzev Hashem, and the Rebbeinu Shlomo got angry, and he says, none of you in this generation will see Eretz Yisrael, except Yeshua and Kalev. Even the big ones, even Moshe and Aaron. And Moshe Rabbeinu says, Gam ki yisanav bi Hashem b'yilalchem. Because of you, Hashem got angry at me. I mean, to say, even though the Meimariva, hitting the stone was his own sin, but it was only because Klal Yisrael's Amunah was already weakened from the Meraglim that hitting the stone in front of them, he should have been more careful knowing that they have Yishrach Amunah at that point. And therefore, he's not going to go into Eretz Yisrael. And as well, he can't go into Eretz Yisrael because Moshe Rabbeinu's whole command was, take the people out of Mitzrayim to Eretz Yisrael. Once those people are not going, there's no more Moshe Rabbeinu going to Eretz Yisrael. It's now time for Yeshua ben Nun. And him, Oysa Chazek, strengthen him because he's going to Yarshan Eretz Yisrael for us.